I've been standing here with you. I've been standing right here with you, Troy. I gave up 18 years of my life just to stand in the same spot as you. What about me? Don't you think I ever wanted to lay around somewhere and forget about my responsibilities? Don't you think I have wants and needs? What about me? Oh, what about my life? I have wants and needs too, Troy. But I took all my wants, my needs, my hopes, my dreams, my feelings, and I buried them inside you. I planted a seed, and I watched, and I prayed over it. I planted myself in you, and I waited to bloom. And it didn't take me no 18 years to figure out that the soil was rocky and hard and I was never gonna bloom. But I held on to you, Troy. And I held on tight because you was mine. And I was yours. See, you're always talking about what you give and what you don't get, but you take too. You take. You didn't even know nobody was giving.
Can I ask you a question? Pops. I said, can I ask you a question?
What the hell you gotta ask me?
How come you never like me?
Like you? Who the hell said I gotta like you? Question. What's all states I gotta like you? Come here, boy. You put the word sir at the end of the words that you talking to me in my house.
Yes, sir.
You eat every day.
Yes, sir.
I put a roof over your head.
Yes, sir.
I put the clothes on your back.
Yes, sir.
Why do you think that is?
It's because of you.
I know it's because of me. Why do you think that is?
Because you like me.
Like you? Let's get this straight before we go any further. I don't have to like you. I gave you life. I gave you everything. I owe a responsibility to you. You understand that, boy?
Yes, sir.
Now get the hell out of my face and get back to work. Now!
What you giving me?
What the hell you say, boy?
What the hell have you ever given me? You ain't never gave me nothing. You ain't never done nothing but hold me back, afraid I was gonna be better than you. All you ever did was try and make me scared of you. I used to tremble every time you called my name. Every time I heard your footsteps in this house. Wondering all the time, what's Pop gonna say if I do this? What's Pop gonna say if I do that? What's Pop gonna say if I turn on the damn radio? And Mom too, she tries but she's scared of you. I don't know how she stands you after what you did to her. So what are you gonna do? Give me a whooping? Can't whoop me no more. You're too damn old. You're just an old man.
shuttling you off to?
Oh, stupid Florida. What about you?
Stupid Vermont.
Vermont? Like in White Christmas?
What you talking about?
You've never seen White Christmas? It's beautiful. And made in Vermont. It's a classic.
You sure know a lot about movies.
I guess. My dad's a movie producer.
Do you live in Hollywood?
Yeah.
Are your parents divorced?
No.
Lucky. Mine are. And we're poor. My mom's just a waitress.
Mine fans people's parties.
That sounds a lot more fun.
I guess.
You must get a lot of good Christmas presents.
I'm Jewish. We have mommy instead.
Do you get presents for it?
8 days worth.
Whoa. You have an incredible life.
Well, I'd rather go to Vermont than stupid Florida. Who lives there, your dad?
No. We don't talk to him. Ever since he married a 20-year-old, my mom said he's a bad influence. I'm gonna go visit my cousins. I haven't seen them in 5 years.
Wow, 5 years?
My mom had to give me a photo just so I could recognize them. What kind of Christmas is that?
A white one? Are you gonna play in the snow?
I guess. I wanna go someplace warm. My mom said they have this main street that gets all lit up. Kids bring their sleds, their Santa's workshop, reindeer, even hot chocolate. Dude, are you okay?
I'm Ira. Ira Finkelstein.
Finkelstein? That's funny.
What's yours?
I'm Michelle. Michelle Amato.
Michelle, this is going to be the Christmas of our dreams.
What you talking about, Ira?
We are going to switch places so you can get a warm Christmas and I can get a white Christmas. And it will be awesome because your family has never seen you and my family has never seen me and...
Dude.
Yeah?
Don't you notice anything different?
Thank you.
Okay, can we drop this? I wasn't looking at the other guy's apartment.
Oh, please! I saw you checking out his moldings. You don't want it!
Why would I want a new apartment? I already have one that I love.
Well, wouldn't kill you to say it once in a while.
All right, you want the truth?
I want the truth!
You really want the truth?
Yeah, I want the truth!
You can't handle the truth!
You good, man?
Yeah, I like that movie.
Oh, I love that movie.
Tom Cruise.
Oh, he's hot.
All right, whatever. You know what? I'm thinking about it.
What?
Well, I'm an adult now, okay? And I'm at a point in my life where I have enough money that I don't need a roommate anymore.
Whoa, whoa, whoa! Whoa! I don't need a roommate either, okay? I can afford this place by myself.
What do you get so bent out of shape for? It's not like we agreed to live together forever. It's not like we're Bert and Ernie.
Look, if this is how you feel, then maybe you should take it.
Well, that's how I feel.
Then maybe you should take it.
Then maybe I will.
Fine with me.
Great.
Ay, 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 hermosa Joanna. You look so sweet.
Sweet.
It's for a good cause.
War is a good cause, Amanda.
Going on a hunger strike is for a good cause. Putting on this stupid costume and making a fool of myself? It's just been ridiculous.
Ridiculous, Joanna. Do you want to disappoint all those kids out there?
Like, I'm not going to be a disappointment to them. There's like a couple that can have these amazing poodles. And I'm going to get a drawn with a dumbass.
What's that?
The Woodsman. He's the one that introduces the show.
He wears tights?
They're not that tight.
You can see right through them.
Only if you're looking.
I'm gonna look like a green poodle.
Listen, Joanna. They hired you to run this kids program for 2 months. I took it off your hands, and all I'm asking you is just 1 day from you in return. You're not doing this for me, I'm giving your job back. Ascultă-mă, Joanna, te-au angajat să conduci programul ăsta de copii pentru 2 luni. Eu doar îți cer o zi din timpul tău. Dacă nu vrei să faci lucrul ăsta pentru mine, nu e nicio problemă. Eu îți dau jobul înapoi.
Ok.
And here's your next costume.
What the hell is that?
Pelerina Roșie.
Who?
Little Red Riding Hood. Without her, we lost our show.
And with her, I lost my reputation.
Prom. date with Darian tonight, and I pass out from nervousness. Is it better to faint into the food or onto the floor?
Well, if it were me, I would faint right into his arm because he is so hot.
That is an advanced move for you, so you may not be ready for it.
Okay, Marissa, I'm serious, all right? I really, really like this boy, and I need your help. What if he thinks I'm boring?
You just have to... You're a spy, for crying out loud! You met royalty! And you've been in the same room as the President of the United States. Obama, not Trump.
So all the things I did not tell him, anything that's unique about me, is classified, remember?
Or gross, like that giant wart on my foot.
Yeah, try not to mention that to him. Or anyone. Like, ever.
Okay, so all I can tell him is that I have a great family. I go to school and I come home.
To my great family.
Well, make something up. Girl, this day needs to work. We need this.
Okay, why do you care?
Thanks to your day, Darian, I got 13 hays, 10 what's good, and I walked my group today. They didn't even come to a complete halt. They didn't ignore me. Y'all know I like to sing, so I just start saying, like, send me your location, let's focus on communicating, cause I just need the time and place to come through. Send me Thank you.
Eli was looking for you.
Eli?
Yeah.
Like Eli McAllister?
Oh my god, he is the cutest boy ever.
What did he say?
Just.
Yeah, what did the boy say?
I'm still telling you.
Yeah, well, hurry.
Just said, hey, you see Pat and he's borrowed history notes.
No way. Shut up.
No, I think you may be overreacting to this news.
Oh, come on. Don't you get it?
No. I don't think I do.
Okay, well, wait. Was he all?
Hey, have you seen Kat? I need to borrow her history notes.
Or was he all? Hey, have you seen Kat?
I need to borrow her history notes. You are so being weird.
What's that supposed to mean?
Nothing.
You call me weird.
I was kidding.
Okay, yeah. Well, in the fifth grade, my best friend, Shelley Markowitz, called me weird, then she didn't invite me to her birthday party, and there was a pony and ice cream cake, and she knew! The pony's ice cream cake was my two favorite things in the entire world, and that was the end of our entire friendship!
Well. You can come to my next birthday party, and I'll have a pony and ice cream cake, because I know! The ponies and ice cream cake are all your two favorite things ever, so you're gonna come to the party.
Uh-huh.
We're gonna have a amazing time.
Yeah.
Eyeliner.
Okay.
car, then lasso a cow with her guitar string.
That would actually slash the cow's head off.
Yes. Yes, it would.
But lucky for the cow, none of that's ever gonna happen because we're just friends.
Yeah, best friends, nothing more.
Why are you looking at me like that?
Why are you looking at me like that? Okay, on the count of three, let's stop staring at each other. Deal?
Deal.
One, two, three. I don't know what happened. Let's do that again. One, two, three. Last time. One, two, three. Okay, that was weird.
Yeah, I think I had more chemistry with my pet pig.
I think I should be insulted.
Don't be. He's the George Clooney of pigs.
About your dress. You should be worried about your shoes!
Poor Gold!
Damn, Daniel. See, if you're going to be dancing in a circle, you're going to need maximum traction. I heard last year Sheila Tanton slipped and wiped out the entire dessert table. She was so embarrassed her entire family had to move to Alaska.
Don't you lie to me. I heard that her dad just got a new job.
At the same time, coincidence? I think not. So, what are you going to be doing for your dance?
Oh, the dance? So I was thinking a little something like this. Kick and kick and kick.
Oh,
okay, just
maybe I'll understand this time.
Last time! Who's on first? What's on second? I don't know who's on first!
Well, I don't know their names either, and if you would just tell me, we can do the game!
Don't you get it? I'm telling you their names! Their names are puns! 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 Who's on first? What's on second? I don't know who's on third.
Oh, yeah. I still don't get it.
Maybe there's a you here at night? It's not someone who's seen the light. It's a cold and it's a broken hallelujah. 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 Hallelujah.
Dad's health to think about. You are going to stay in this room and you are going to figure out a story. I don't care who, I don't care where, I don't care. Somebody stole the money, you got robbed, but that is what you are going to do. And that is the story you are going to tell your father, because if you tell him the truth, you are going to kill that man as sure as I'm sitting here. Tonight, after your dad goes to sleep, you and I are going to go into the kitchen and we are going to figure this out alone.
I don't give a shit what you do.
Excuse me?
No one ever thought about me. I'm just the crackhead of the family, right? I'm also the youngest. And I have been working extra to keep Dad alive. Not you! Dad's gonna die anyway, Mom. He's sick. So it doesn't matter if it's sooner or later. So yeah, I took the money to numb myself from all the damn pressure! So screw you! Y'all don't give a shit about me anyway.
You know what, Stacy? Go!
Face all messed up.
What does Tony have to do with anything?
He didn't tell you what happened.
He said he fell down some steps. What does that have to do with anything?
Just as I got here, I saw him with Patricia out back in the cemetery.
It's bullshit.
Ask him! You make sure you ask her in front of Patricia. I saw them with my own eyes. He had them bent over a tombstone, and she sure wasn't objecting to that. But if you ask him in front of Patricia, if you know your boy as well as you think you know him, you'll see the dead truth written all over his face. And if you know that little sister of yours at all, you'll see it there too. And I'll tell you what, if that doesn't satisfy you, I'd be more than happy to put an end to all you Donna boys.
Talk to you for a sec. Yeah, look.
just wanted to say,
let me guess, you were just trying to impress your new friends? Or maybe you forgot who I was and you didn't know who to stick up for. Oh, I know. Over the summer, you just got cooler than everybody else.
Okay, I deserve that. I'm sorry. I just wanted you to know. I didn't know it was gonna go that far.
It's not like you even tried to stop them. Spare me the explanation.
Hey, just listen.
What?
I don't even know them. They asked me to go with them. I thought we were going to the track while Julie drooled over her boyfriend.
Look, Tabitha, I don't care who you hang out with, just don't bother me anymore, okay?
Hey, I think you broke one of Julie's teeth. I gotta say, that was pretty cool.
She's got a big mouth. It was an easy target.
Fight like that!
I take a Krav Maga over the weekends. It's a self-defense class.
I don't know what that is, but that sounds so cool!
Well, you gotta go.
Can you teach me some of that Lady Gaga?
Krav Maga.
That one. Are you busy?
So let me get this straight. You want to come over and let me kick your ass? You do know that I can really hurt. How's Saturday around noon? Right, great, each of them.
What?
I mean, I'll see them.
Hey buddy, how was work?
It was so long, I can't wait to get out of these clothes and just relax.
Yeah, about that, I have some really good news.
Oh really? What is it?
I scored us a double date!
You what?
I scored us a double date! Tonight, so go get changed, or we're gonna give it an hour. At Huggies.
I don't do dates.
Why not?
I just don't.
What, are you scared?
No, it's just...
Just what?
It's just... Okay, I'm scared.
Look, man, you need to get out. All you have to do is go to work and come home. That's not normal!
I wouldn't know what to say.
That's easy. You talk about yourself. You ask about herself. Girls love to talk about themselves.
I don't know.
Okay, we'll do a little role play.
A what?
I'll pretend to be a girl and you come up and talk to me.
Okay, that's a little bit weird.
Yeah.
You done?
Yeah. Bye, Susan. Timber.
You know, we wouldn't even be lost in the first place if it wasn't for this stupid compass. Where'd you get this thing anyway?
In a box of Fruity Pebbles.
Tracy, when the summer camp said to bring a compass, I really don't think that they meant to get one from the bottom
of the box! I'm sorry, I was in a hurry to pack and needed a compass. Even one that doesn't work. Besides, don't blame the compass, you have a really bad sense of direction.
What? So you're telling me
this is a forest? Isn't this where bears hang out?
No, because wouldn't there be a bunch of signs that say, don't feed the bears?
Well, I don't want to be the one that feeds the bears, but do bears make little girls?
Hey, I'm not little.
Yeah, you're deliciously plump.
Line. Oh yeah. It was all bowed up in that.
Yeah.
be nervous. You're a great dancer. You get it from my side of the family. You're welcome.
But what if they put a spotlight on me?
A spotlight? Well, then you bite your bottom lip and you go for it.
Huh?
Go for it, girl! Like now. Get your vogue on, biatch!
nowhere.
Yeah, but then it found an umbrella.
Found? It was attached to the hot dog cart.
Boy, was he mad.
Who knew sauerkraut could be used as a weapon?
Yeah, I know. Tell me about it.
I just did.
You know what, Jenny? I really had a great time today.
No!
Face in the face! Why did you do that?
Because I'm trying to keep things from being awkward between us.
The only thing that can make things more awkward if I lose a limb.
Oh, come on. All day, you've been trying to get with this.
I have not been trying to get with that.
First, you bring a romantic picnic.
They were left over from my mom's poker game last night.
Okay. But then you said I was one of the two prettiest guys you've ever seen.
That's not exactly a compliment.
Oh, true. But then you tried to kiss me.
I was reaching for my jacket, man.
Oh. Well, this is awkward. Oh, wait. If you didn't want to kiss me, then why did you invite me to the park?
Because you're new in town and you don't have any friends. Now I know why.
Pretty sure, I can say. Okay, look, this isn't Sesame Street, honey. This is prom. It's just prom. Now let me tell you how prom works, okay? At prom, we compare notes.
Notes?
Yeah, notes.
I don't have any notes.
Okay, this is how we're gonna do it. I'm going to tell you everything you need to know to be fully prepared for this, okay?
C.
And you're gonna write it down. Got it?
Got it.
Ready?
C.
Okay. First of all, you need to remember that at prom, the restrooms can become like what? There's gonna be girls in here, scattered around all over the place, going over strategies and collecting weapons.
Weapons?
And you just gotta be exactly like them, but even more. You need to go in there, find a spot, and start mapping out everything.
Wait, I don't have a map.
You need to know exactly what you're gonna do, when you're gonna do it, where you're gonna do it, and how you're gonna do it. You need to be confident and strong. You need to have all of your weapons, gunpowder, straps, and ammunition. Especially your ammunition. And you just need to go in there and be like, boom, boom, pow!
I don't think I want to go to prom. I mean, no weapons, gunpowder, ammunition. What does it mean, ammunition?
Makeup. The stealth bomber of adolescence.
Yeah, I know. No. At least the PhD entertainment and you're just too much for me. I'm so confusion right now.
Slow dances. Be aware of the slow dances.
Slow dances. My people don't do that.
Yeah.
Okay. Hit it, Jose.